What does the PS4 open up for you creatively?
Well, it's less what it's opened up for me, because at PlayStation, I work on the developer relations team, and we seek out independent developers who are making content, and we want to bring it to PlayStation. So with PlayStation 4, because it's so much easier to program for than PlayStation 3, we found it much easier to go out and seek cool indie content. For example, this game, Mercenary Kings, was originally announced as a PC Kickstarter. So we saw that game, realized the PS4 architecture isn't that different than the PC, so we reached out to them, sent them some development kits, and helped them to get onto the platform.
How is the game taking advantage of the PS4's capabilities?
So Mercenary Kings takes advantage of a lot of the different, you know, online functionality of PS4. You can jump into other people's games. It's a full online four-player multiplayer experience. So the ease of use of online, that's part of it. It also uses the controller in a few cool ways. It uses the touch panel. But really, it's more just like the ability for them to port this game from PC to PlayStation 4 so quickly and easily. That's you know, it's not exactly a graphical showcase in terms of polygons. It's actually a 2D hand-drawn game. But you know, I think this shows that we really do still love old-fashioned sprite-based games on PS4. It doesn't have to be a 3D game for us to get behind it.
What's the story behind the game world?
It's kind of a wacky, unique, it's hard. I wouldn't want to do any disservice, but imagine the 80s vision of war, kind of the Rambo / Metal Slug, that version of warfare, and you're deep in that, and you're a mercenary, and you're kind of amassing this group of other mercenaries with you, and it's wacky and wild and a little cartoony, but yet still really violent. It treads a line between absurd and realistic.
Who are players controlling, and what experiences can they have?
Well, so, you know, four players, it's always cooperative. You're not trying to kill each other, you're actually helping each other out in this game. And because you're crafting new weapons and learning new abilities, it really actually, you know, what you bring into battle matters, what weapons you bring, how much ammo. And some of the bosses in this game are incredibly hard. So you'll actually need to bring three of your friends together with good armaments online to fight a certain boss. In that way, it's kind of similar to games like Monster Hunter, in that you actually do have to, like, really strategize with your friends.
How do you feel that the gameplay pushes the game forward?
This is a game that's all about trial and error, of like checking out, you know, new weapons. You're always like, you're finding all these new items and you're combining them to form new weapons and just kind of experimenting with different types of gameplay. And, you know, it's a really tough game at first. When I first started playing it, I was getting killed all the time. And you actually do learn how to reload your weapons on the fly without, you know, because it's actually kind of a skill shot. As you run out of ammo, if you press the R button at the right time, you reload instantly instead of having to wait to reload. So there's kind of some small little skill-based things that really make it a lot more fun.
Can you talk a little bit about the multiplayer?
Sure. You know, it's kind of a drop-in, drop-out system. You can tackle the game single-player throughout, or at any time, you can have your friends join your game, either, you know, a combination of people in front of your TV. You can actually do four-player split-screen, or you can even do two people in front of the couch with two people online. So no matter where you are, you can always have a four-player game.